Hello everyone and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to freeze a smoke simulation in Blender. There are two things that I will be demonstrating in this video, and the first one is how to have a single frame of smoke throughout the entire animation, and the other one is how to pause the smoke simulation and resume it at a different point in the timeline. This can be very useful if you want to create an explosion where the simulation stops, the camera moves to a different position in the scenes, and then the explosion continues and it looks pretty interesting. To get started, you actually need to set up a smoke simulation, so I'm going to scale down this cube and then go over to Object, down to Quick Effects, and then Quick Smoke. Jumping over to the Physics tab, I'm going to turn on Adaptive Domain so it bakes in a little bit faster, and High Resolution. With a high resolution of 3, I'm going to go ahead and bake in this simulation. Now you might notice on the right side that it's currently grayed out, and that is because we need to save our project. So I'm going to press Ctrl S to save my Blender file. Once we save our Blender file, you'll notice that the cache is now not grayed out anymore, so we can bake in our simulation. So I'm going to bake in 50 frames right here, so I'm going to type in 50. And then I'm going to click on bake. The baking is now done. Now if I jump over to frame 50, we can see how this looks. Now let's say, for example, I really like how this frame looks and I want this to start at frame 1. To do this, what we need to do is open up the folder of where our baking cache went to. The folder will be in the exact spot where you saved your Blender file, so just go open up that folder. Then you should see a folder called Blender Cache and then whatever you named your Blender file. If we open up this, we can see all of the different frames for our smoke. So now what we need to do is hit Ctrl A to select everything, then holding Ctrl, I'm going to click on the frame that I actually like to deselect it. Then all you have to do is right click and go delete. So every single frame of our smoke simulation is now deleted except for frame 50. Now if we go back over to Blender, then if we play this, you'll notice it's in the exact same spot all throughout this animation. It's not moving, it's just frozen in place. So there you go, that is how you have one single frame of your smoke simulation throughout the entire animation. Now let's learn how to pause the smoke and then resume it at a different point. To get started, what we need to do is duplicate our smoke domain. So I'm going to hold Shift and select both of these objects, the flow object and the smoke object, and then I'm going to hit Shift D and then right click. Let's go ahead and move this to a new collection so we don't get confused. So I'm going to go New Collection and I'm just going to go 2. So now we have our first smoke domain in our first collection and our second one in the second collection. I'm going to go ahead and press 1 to go to the first collection so it hides the other one. Select your domain and then scroll down to the baking cache. Here is where you determine where you want the baking to pause. So let's say, for example, I want it to go for 50 frames and then I want it to pause for 25 frames and resume after that. So at frame 50, I'm just going to go ahead and click bake, and we can see it starting to bake down here. All right, there we go. It's baked in 50 frames. So now let's go to the second collection and do the other smoke domain. So I'm going to hit 2 to go to this collection, and then I'm going to select my domain. And here we can bake in a new cache, and you are going to want to name this. So I'm just going to type in 2. So we have two different baking caches, and they won't overwrite each other. Then from here, we just have to do a little bit of math. So let's say I want my smoke simulation to pause for 50 frames and resume at 100. So basically, this start frame, I need to go to 50. Since our first smoke domain is 50 frames long, once it resumes at 100, it'll be in the exact same position as our first simulation. So then the end frame can just be whatever you want. So let's go with 150, so it lasts for another 50 frames. Then all we have to do is click on bake. So basically how this works is you take the pause length and then you add that to the simulation start. In this case, it's paused for 50 frames. So all I do is take that pause length and put that in for the simulation start right here. And then of course the end frame can be whatever you want. Now that we've done that, let's go ahead and bring in our first collection, which is collection 1. And now what we need to do is come over to the outliner right here, open up this panel and turn on the camera icon. Now what we are going to do is animate this camera icon so it disappears after a certain amount of time. So at frame 99 with the first smoke simulation selected, I'm going to hover over the camera icon and then hit I. Then go to the next frame, which would be frame 100, uncheck this and then hit I one more time so it disappears. We also need to do that for the smoke domain as well. So I'm going to hover over at frame 99, uncheck this, then hit I, go over to the next frame, frame 100, turn this on, and then hit I one more time. And there we go, now this should play properly. Unfortunately, you can't animate this eye icon in the viewport, but this will work in the rendered view. Then from there, all you have to do is set up your animation. You can move your camera around while it's paused and then resume it at that point, and you can create some very interesting results. So there you go, guys. That is how you freeze a smoke simulation in Blender. Thank you for watching. If you created your own simulation or animation, I would love to see it, so make sure to send it to me over on Instagram. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like and comment down below what you would like to see a tutorial on next.